It's a real challenge to balance employee productivity with data security. Take email, for example. Employees need easy access to email to stay productive, but organizations want to ensure that only protected devices can access corporate email. The way to achieve the balance your organization needs is to take advantage of conditional access policies in Microsoft Intune. You'll gain the ability to restrict access to email and other corporate resources based on device enrollment and compliance policies set by your IT. It's a win-win. IT sets device requirements, and employees gain access to corporate email and resources only if they meet those requirements. Let's see how conditional access works from the perspective of an employee. Usually, the first thing you're going to do on a new device as an employee is set up your email account. Let's try it out on an iPad. To get started, go to Settings, then go to Mail, Contacts, Calendars, and then tap Add Account. We've already got a corporate email account set up for this demo, so let's move on to the next step. Okay, with your account all set up, you'll want to test out your email to see if it's working. But when conditional access is enabled within Intune, you won't initially have access to your email. Instead, you'll receive an email informing you that your device is temporarily blocked from accessing email until you complete the Intune enrollment steps. As you can see here, there is a link in the email to enroll your device, which requires you to first install the Microsoft Intune company portal. You will then follow a few simple enrollment steps, and you'll have access to corporate email. Okay. Now let's see how conditional access can be configured from the Intune admin console. Before enabling conditional access policies with Intune, run the mobile device inventory report to see which devices will lose access to email and other corporate resources when conditional access is enabled. This gives you the option as an IT administrator to inform impacted users before blocking their access to email if their devices are not enrolled or compliant. The next step is to create a compliance policy using Intune. Compliance policies allow you to check for specific settings on a device and ensure that these settings are enabled before the device gains access to email. Settings such as requiring a password, encrypting data, and detecting if the device is jailbroken can be verified to make sure that a device is compliant. After you set up compliance policies, the next step is to enable conditional access for specific services, such as Exchange Online, Exchange On-Premises, and SharePoint Online. Let's go ahead and enable conditional access for Exchange Online. Next, you'll need to decide which groups to apply these policies to. Let's choose the Marketing Execs group. As soon as conditional access is enabled, users from this group will lose access to their email if their devices are not enrolled or compliant. You can also specify groups that are exempted from conditional access policies. Exempted users do not need to enroll their devices with Intune or be compliant in order to access corporate email. That's it. Now you know how to enable users to be productive while protecting corporate data at the same time, all by taking advantage of conditional access policies with Microsoft Intune.